Cheesy Jokes with Sarah,
TRM Interview,
Prescott's Got Talent,
and more on this week's
Roadrunner Report. Another Roadrunner Report.
It's Friday, December 2nd.
So let's get a move on.
Hey, Sarah, we have a great singer on campus.
Oh, yeah? Who?
Bobby Hernandez's brother is singing Thinking Out Loud by Ed Sheeran.
Nice. Let's watch it.
When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? 'Cause darling, I will be loving you till 70. And baby, my heart could still fall as hard at 23. And now I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways. Maybe it's all part of a plan. Well, me, I fall in love with you every single day, and I just wanna tell you I am. So honey, now take me into your loving arms. Kiss me under the light of 1,000 stars. Oh darling, place your hand on my beating heart. Thinking out loud, maybe we found love right where we are. Maybe we found love right where we are. And we found love right where we are.
When should you bring your father to class?
I don't know.
When you have a pop quiz.
That's funny.
Now there's a new segment with me called Cheesy Jokes with Sarah.
Let's joke on in.
Welcome to Cheesy Jokes with Sarah. All right, Emma. Why didn't the computer go to prom? It didn't have a data.
That's pretty sad.
Okay, Stefan, I'm gonna tell you a joke. Why did Cinderella get thrown off the baseball team?
Because she was white.
Because she kept running away from the ball. Stefan, I'm gonna tell you a cheesy joke, okay? Why did the rooster cross the road? Because he didn't want to be chicken. You guys want to hear a cheesy joke?
Sure.
Okay. Why did the lady work at the glue company?
I don't know.
Because it was fast paced. Do you guys want to hear a cheesy joke?
Of course.
Sure. Okay.
Of course.
What's green and sings?
Elvis Presley.
You guys want to hear another cheesy joke?
Of course.
All right. Yeah. Why did the comedian put his running shoes on?
Why?
Because he wanted to tell a running joke. Do you guys want to hear a cheesy joke?
Sure.
All right. What has a head and a tail, but no body?
A river?
A coin!
Have you seen the recycling bins around campus?
Yeah, they're really handy.
Well, we interviewed Diego Gomez, a former Prescott student, who built the recycling bins with his Boy Scout troop.
Oh, really? That's so cool.
Let's watch it.
Hey, Roadrunners, it's Olivia, and I'm here with Diego Gomez. And he has made recycling bins for our school, and they've helped so much. So I'm going to be interviewing him about those about those recycling bins. So first off, I heard that you got an Eagle Scout badge. What does it take to get that badge?
To get an Eagle requirement badge, you need to first get your 22 required merit badges as well as 11 that are Eagle, and the rest are just need to be like regular merit badges. Also, you need to make sure that you do an Eagle project, which is what I did, and the Eagle project needs to benefit the community as well as allow them to be able to participate in future occasions for it. And that's why I did the Eagle project of making recycling bins.
Yeah, I definitely benefited the community. What Boy Scout troop are you from?
I'm from Troop 13 of Modesto.
Oh, nice. And how long have you been a Boy Scout, and what makes you want to come back every year?
I've been a Boy Scout since January of 2011, and I just love doing Boy Scouts because you can do a bunch of events, you can go to many places, and it gives you a chance to like experience things that people that are not Boy Scouts could experience.
5 years. Wow, yeah. That's awesome. About the bins, what inspired you to make the bins?
Well, I've always been hearing around that there's been a lot of recycling bins here, but they don't really are used for that. They're mainly just used for the regular trash, and they're not really made for what they're for. So I thought that if you made recycling bins, that they can actually be used, and
yeah,
people wouldn't just throw trash wherever they wanted to, and it would actually contribute to like the school's requirements for staying clean, I guess.
Yeah, definitely. Who helped you, if anyone did, make the recycling bins?
I had quite a bit of help from my troop family and friends. They all helped me try to do it in a few days, and it was quite a big help for them.
Yeah. How long? You said just a few days, or?
Well, the actual building took a few days, but the planning took many months because you have to get approvals. You have to make sure you get it signed by the council, and you also have to make sure that your troop approves it, and it's just quite a bit of plan that you need to do.
Yeah, I bet. Let's see. Were you a former Prescott student?
Yes, I was.
What school do you go to now?
I go to Gregory High School.
What grade?
11th grade.
That's awesome. Okay, I think that he has brought some models and some papers that he'd like to show us, so I'm going to let him do that.
I brought a model here. It's a scaled-down version of a recycling bin that I made. And this is how it opens. It's made out of a cookie box, but yeah.
Yeah.
And it's scaled down from 6 times. So like this is the scale. And in here is where you can put all the different parts. So you can put here trash, bottles, cans, and you can also put some compost here. And what this does as an opening is you can store the trash cans in here or the bins, and you can make sure that they go into the right spot and then take them out. And also, I brought this binder. It basically just outlines what you need to do. So like, you can do, what you need to do is your project proposal, project plan, project report. And then once you're done with that, you can start doing your project. But the thing is, you have to make sure you get it signed in order for it to be good to
go. Wow, very organized. That one looks exactly like the one that's over by the recycling. Big one in the over by the bathrooms. That's awesome. Well, thank you for the interview, and I really appreciate you making the recycling for
our
school. It really helped.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hey, Roller Runners! This week we're having a raffle for those who've already bought their yearbook.
If you've already bought a yearbook, your name's been assigned a number between 1 and 216. If your number gets picked according to this random number generator we have, you're the winner.
Each of them will be receiving a card for either Starbucks, Target, or Jamba Juice.
Let's pick a winner! Our first winner is number 132, who is Tyler Palmatier. And then our second winner is number 99, who is Carcia Laterno. So if you're the winner, come up to the office at either break or lunch to get your prize. We'll be doing another drawing next week and the week after, so if you want to win some more great prizes, go ahead and buy your yearbook. It's available in the office or at jostens.com, and the current price is $32, but it's going to go up to $34 on December 23rd, so get yours today.
Hi, I'm here with Isabel, and Isabel's going to give a shout-out.
Hi, Mom.
Starbucks.
Myself.
My mom.
Sean Mendez.
Hi, I'm here with some fellow Roadrunners, and I'm going to be asking them a question. So, guys,
What's your favorite dance move?
I have to say whip. I have no idea what mine's called.
I don't know what mine's whip. Called either.
Whip.
Okay. Whip.
Wow!
Yo, dudes, we got a random clip of the day just for you.
That's right.
Let's go.
Hit it.
I got beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, yams, hog, moss.
I got greens, beans, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkey, rabbit,
you name it.
We have an update about TRM.
Yeah, we do. I went out and interviewed Ms. Kleinfelder to see how they're doing on their season.
Nice, let's run on in.
Hi, I'm here with Mrs. Kleinfelder, and I'm going to be interviewing her about TRM. So what made you want to continue doing TRM here?
I think TRM is a really great program that Mr. Olson and Ms. Pengree started here. I think this is about the 8th or 9th year for TRM here at Prescott. And it's just a great program to teach kids things that they didn't know about themselves. Perseverance, having to put in a lot of time. It's a 6-month program of us running 4 days a week. So perseverance is a big thing that you learn. You learn a lot about yourself, though, when you're out running for a long time.
How do you think the kids are doing so far?
We have just an amazing team this year. They are very, very, very fast. They've been doing a great job. It's really fun to see this year.
So how many miles have you guys been doing?
So far, our longest run was this last Saturday, and it was 6 miles. However, tomorrow, people running a full marathon will be running 12 miles.
Wow.
So it's kind of a big jump. But we'll be running in the park, and there'll be aid stations for them because they'll need to eat during that kind of a run. They'll need to hydrate during that kind of a run. Good news is it will be kind of cool, which will help.
Have you seen any progress in your kids so far?
I've seen progress. I know that they've also seen progress. People are starting to have faster times when they're running in PE. You guys are up to, you know, 2-mile runs, 3-mile runs. And we've also gotten, I think, 2 or 3 new red trunkers on our team. And considering this is just a shot out there for last year, 5 of the 6 gold trunkers were TRM members. So it does really help not only your running, but also just your endurance and your whole body.
Thank you for the interview.
Thank you. You guys have a good day.
You too.
Go Gabby!
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 Well, that's it for this week's show.
Hope it was a good one.
Have a great weekend and stay warm.
Thanks for watching. Sleeping in.
Yeah, same. Our reporters went out and asked.
Just keep going.
I'm horrible. Sure.